Hello, everyone, and check it out. I am playing Fallout 4. Why am I playing Fallout 4? Well, I mean, the obvious, or the actual reason, is I want to ensure that I have a new character set up for when I decide to go and start playing the upcoming DLC packs. I already have the season pass purchased, ready to go, just waiting to get started on that. So I wanted to start a new character, but, you know, that's not necessarily the reason why I'm making this video. While I was playing through this game, I thought about a few things, like how a person's opinion on something can change after the fact. Like, for example, there are a lot of games out there that I really liked while playing through the first time, but when I look back on it, as little as like immediately after I finished playing it, playing through the game and decided I'm done with it and I'm going to move on, my opinion on it can change. And the further distance you put yourself from something, it seems like the more likely you are to have your opinion change on something like that. So with the game Fallout 4 having a few months removed from the last time I played it, I wanted to see if that opinion I had of this game, which I very much enjoyed, had changed. Well, I mean, the short answer to that is no, it hasn't. So I started to think about, well, why is it then that other people didn't like this game, considering it is, in a lot of ways, very similar to Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas, games that the same people did, in fact, really go out and say that they really enjoyed. So what was it about Fallout 4 that they didn't like when it was, in a lot of ways, the same as Fallout 3 and New Vegas, only with a lot of like structural improvements, I can think. I can say pretty confidently that this game is better than either Fallout 3 or Fallout 4. And it is, I mean, not beloved by the same people in the same way. You can, of course, say that, well, I mean, both technological progression and sort of gameplay-wise, the game is out of date. It doesn't really do things that a lot of other games have done better or something like that. So you think about, say, The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt is the obvious example that I'm going to be coming to. A lot of people look at this game, what is that? I do not remember that. The Witcher 3 is the obvious example that a lot of people drew criticism of this game. There's a truck at the top of a tree there. The Witcher 3 is to what a lot of people made comparisons to. Well, I mean, it's nice and all right, but it doesn't, you know, do this or doesn't do that. And you're basically pointing out things, saying like, well, I mean, The Witcher did this and I like this, so I think Fallout should have done this. And all that kind of thing. And that's not saying that's a bad thing to do. I mean, the industry learns from the other members of the industry so they can... Everybody, like, steals each other's ideas, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. That's how everything ends up getting better, is by people stealing other people's ideas. What am I going over here? There's that weird thing over there I wanted to see. Is that a radio tower? But I do have a little bit of a problem with people saying that Fallout should have been more like The Witcher, because in my mind they are two very different games. Now, we sort of have an overly restrictive way of referring to everything, like, well, this is an action adventure RPG that is a military first-person shooter, that is a blah blah blah, a platformer. Holy crap. Ah, stupid blood bugs. I hate these things. They're hard to kill.
Will you be able to make another steam pack soon? You should wash your hands after that. It can be unsanitary to handle the disease.
Nice. Almost at a level up. Uh Oh, okay. That was part of her quest, wasn't it? Not one that I'm on, though, so that's weird. Yeah. So, you make the comparison between this and The Witcher, and, like, they are different games, even though you would say that they're both action-adventure RPGs. And I guess we really do have to do that kind of thing. We can't really get away from fairly simplistic definitions and explanations and descriptions of what games are, because it really does get to be a little bit too much. Like, you look at different genres of music, how many different versions of each specific genre exist because level up exist because
humanity is so resilient to cling to life despite all of this. It is the duty of us all to further that survival.
Were you talking to a tree or these dogs?
Someone is nearby. Perhaps.
Lots of different sub-genres of music have cropped up, and it can make really, like, a lot of difficulty in determining, like, oh no, this isn't this type, it's this very subtly different type, and just remembering all of these names is like a full-time job. So it does kind of make sense that we kind of have to lump these together in, say, the action RPG genre. But then I begin to wonder, like, should... It does give us the problem of saying that this and The Witcher are very similar games. Now, like, let me draw up a few differences between the two, and why Fallout really shouldn't have been modeled after what we had seen in The Witcher, aside from the fact that they were released so close to each other, they couldn't really have done much to influence each other. Oh, this is a settlement. It's one of my settlements. I already have this place. Whatever. Like, for example, let's go find somebody. A person. There should be somebody wandering around here. Ah, there you are.
Ain't looking for trouble, I hope.
Okay, this isn't one of my settlements, but it can be. I'm gonna steal your fruit. Because I'm gonna plant it at my places. Look at this woman here. Not really, like, an important character in the game or not, but this is a character in a game. Now, you look at, say, another character, similar kind of person that you'd run across in The Witcher. And just thinking about the way that the game works, you definitely see a few significant changes. In The Witcher, you basically had characters which either stood perfectly still and just sort of announced things as you walked by or completed some sort of scripted action, or were on some sort of, like, sentry route. Where they would just wander around in the circle or something to give, like, the cities and all that kind of stuff a sort of illusion of being a living thing. But the reality is the characters are just stationary things or semi-mobile things that wander around on a predetermined track and do a whole lot of stuff like that. When you wander away from this character, this character stops existing, because the game isn't going to keep track of a lot of things going on in the background that aren't necessary, that aren't considered to be required to for you to play the game. Now, this game is different. That settler that I just talked to, even though I've wandered away, you can't see the character. The character probably isn't even being rendered 3D right now. Is still existing in a way or a form, still going about her task, and will, if enough time passes, wander over, go to sleep, at some point get up, wander over, get something to eat or drink or whatever. And if it's a different, and some other characters may, like, the more options that that character has, the more things that that character is going to do. Even when I am not there to see it happen, it gives the whole world a larger, like, more living and breathing kind of environment. Even if it doesn't look visibly as good as what we had seen in The Witcher, it's still... Don't attack them. I just wanted the plants. I'm a little weirded out by the fact that that thing had bottle caps in it, but whatever. So The Witcher looks better, but in my opinion at least, Fallout feels better because it feels alive. It doesn't feel static. It doesn't feel like it's constrained to a predefined form. It's allowed to live and breathe in a certain respect. And you'll sometimes see weird stuff happen, like an explosion go off in the distance. Why? Look at that car's about to fall over. That's actually a bug. But that's just the kind of thing I could talk about. It spawned in an area that it couldn't stay on. I'm not going to talk to these guys. If you go and... Look, you'll see explosions happening off in the distance, and the reason why that happened is because a character following an AI routine, or AI build, wanders through that environment and stumbles across another character who's following your own AI build, and it wasn't really intended by the developers to happen at this point or anything like that, but they're considered hostile against each other, so they attack each other, and boom, explosions happening. Maybe there was a suicider present, and you see an atomic explosion go off in the distance. You run over there, you see all the corpses of the people who fought the battle. Not the kind of thing that you're going to see happen in The Witcher, because it all has to be pre-scripted. The developers had to have intended for that to happen at that point, or when you reach that area of the environment, or whatever. Wow, this place is in terrible shape. Not to say that something like what we had seen in The Witcher is bad either. It's just a different way of going about things. The Witcher is...
There we go.
Okay. Oh, I'm back here. yeah. Not paying attention to what I'm doing. I want to go that way. The Witcher offers a much more controlled way of going through the game, and that's definitely good in its own way, just it's not something that really should be compared to a way that somebody like something like a Fallout. You have something like in The Witcher where you have the more controlled experience. It's sort of symbolized by the way the main character Geralt is played in the game. Raiders. How did you see me? Alright, let's do this. Mr. Shooty. I'm gonna take your head off. Much tougher than I was expecting. Why do you never use a... This is not going that well, but I'll be alright. There we go. Go out there and engage him with a melee weapon. Oh, now she does have a... Whatever. Hey, what's this do? I'm about to die. Alright, let's do this thing. Stupid raiders. Oh! took a shot to the head. Look at the character of Geralt, and you start to see, like, a sort of weird way that this character interacts with your player decisions and all that kind of stuff. Now, both Fallout and The Witcher have a lot of player agency when it comes to what the character is going to do and all that kind of stuff. Fallout series has always had a little bit more of a blank slate style character as opposed to what you see in a lot of... I'm out of here, this place is messed up. A blank slate style character as opposed to one that's previously constructed and sort of has to follow by a certain moral or something, guidelines, character traits, which inform their kind of actions and all that kind of stuff. Now, my character here, she can go bat crap crazy, do some horrible stuff, and she's going to act like it. No remorse, any of that kind of stuff, while she's going and doing all these evil things. Or if I choose the other way around, she can act like a kind person, or go back and forth, which unfortunately gives a character a sort of psychotic aspect about their personality, or like they're bipolar or something like that. All of a sudden they get angry and all that kind of stuff. And that's just sort of an intrinsic fault of the sort of choose your own path through a game style game world like you see in Fallout. This is somewhere where I think maybe The Witcher does a little bit better in this respect, because the character of Geralt has a personality, and regardless of what kind of decisions you make, his reactions are going to be informed by that personality. Something weird happened in there. Of course, Myalurks and Raiders. Oh, that one's glowing. I'm out of here. Am I heading north? Is there anything north? No, it's not going to be anything north. Now, let's say in The Witcher, you're going to have... let's say you have an option of, I'm going to do this or I'm going to do that. And regardless of what action you take, like, let's say you do the good thing, Geralt will go, yeah, I did the good thing because I do good stuff. Then you go and you compare it to him doing a bad thing. Like, say, taking a person's last dollar or something, or going along with the actions of an evil character because it suits whatever goal he's after. But he doesn't have to like it. It can give a kind of bizarre sort of aspect to his personality. Like, and unfortunately robs you of a bit of a player immersion that this character that you're playing as is supposed to be you. Well, no, you're not really playing as you. You're playing as Geralt, and he's going around making decisions. And if you do something that's against his own personality, he's going to sort of... Yeah, I'm going to do this, but you're still a bastard. Which, I mean, it kind of doesn't really make any sense. Stupid glowing mire lurk. I'm going to take all your stuff. I'm going to rob your corpses, because that's what I do. It's not like I killed you or anything like that. So on one hand, I can look at that kind of thing, and I can think, yeah, that's definitely a better way of going about it. The character sort of justifies in a certain respect or to a certain point his actions when he does something good or does something evil. But on the other hand, it does kind of pull me out of the immersion for a little bit, because, like, well, I mean, yeah, I wanted to be a dickhead, and Geralt didn't want to be a dickhead, and, well, between the two of us, his character build wins out, regardless of what I wanted to do, or how I wanted to picture my character as being. So it's definitely different way. Why is there a barnacle right there? Definitely two very distinct ways of doing it, and they both have their upsides and their downsides. And, that's why the games have to be considered. Wow, that thing. Oh, it floated. That's why I think you need to have these different styles of games, and there is no perfect build, there's no perfect way to go and make this kind of thing. No perfect way of going about it to make everybody happy. That's why saying something like Fallout should have been more like The Witcher is kind of a stupid thing to say, because they should remain different. Obviously, if something just flat out being done better, like a control scheme is better or something like that, then yeah, alright. But just this kind of thing, they really do need to remain different. Stupid lobster monster. Oh, well, anyway. Oh, hey, look at that. It's a lot of these things. It's a weird toothy dolphin. Anyway, that's the end of my little rant here. I'm signing off. Thanks for watching, or listening, or whatever.